There was a really interesting legal development surrounding Michael Cohen, who, of course, the president's personal attorney or fixer, who had his home and apartment and office raided by the FBI. Cohen has dropped libel suits that he had filed in January against Fusion GPS, which created that dossier now that is so important, and also BuzzFeed, which published the dossier. Joining me now is former federal prosecutor Renato Mariotto. Thanks so much for being with us. Let me read you the statement from Michael Cohen's legal team here. They say, given the events that have unfolded and the time, attention, and resources needed to prosecute these matters, we have dismissed the matters despite their merits. Now, I'm not a lawyer, but I don't think it's so simple there. There might be something else going on here. Explain.
Well, this suit, I think, was always a publicity stunt or an effort by Cohen to get the word out that he disagreed with some of the items in the dossier. One problem for Cohen is that in a suit like that, the truth of what happened, the truth of what's underlying that lawsuit, is actually what's going to be discussed and going to be at issue in the lawsuit. So he's essentially saying, in that lawsuit, I believe the dossier is false. Well, Fusion GPS's defense of that can be the dossier is completely true. And then you could imagine you'd have discovery, you'd have a deposition where Mr. Cohen would be questioned under oath about whether the items in the dossier are true or false. That's always a dodgy thing for Mr. Cohen, and particularly now that he's the subject of a federal criminal investigation, you can understand why his lawyers do not want to have a trial about whether or not the dossier is true or false.
Yeah, given he's under criminal investigation, did not want to sit for discovery in this civil case. Not worth the risk there. Fascinating nonetheless. What do you make of the statement from the president's former divorce lawyer, Jay Goldberg, in this phone conversation to the president, which he was only too happy to share with the whole world, by the way, that he feels that Michael Cohen could flip on him?
I will tell you, it's a really interesting statement in my view. If for example, you were asked, can you cooperate and provide testimony regarding one of your associates for criminal wrongdoing, I suspect you wouldn't be able to do it. Most of us aren't insiders in criminal enterprises. We're not able to flip on people. We don't have that sort of insider information. And essentially, what I find interesting about that comment is it presumes that Michael Cohen has information to give. It really is not the sort of the talk about it. Well, will somebody flip on you is something that only people who have criminal exposure talk about. People who aren't involved in criminal activity aren't really concerned about whether other people will flip.
It is interesting. The language you sometimes hear from Trump associates surrounding this entire investigations is interesting. The presumption that Michael Cohen has something in this case, you're suggesting, or when you're talking about the possibility the president might testify, the presumption that he wouldn't be able to tell the truth or that he would get caught lying. The parameters there are fascinating. Independent of that, again, you're a former federal prosecutor right there. What's your experience with people who face this type of pressure in a criminal investigation? Do they often end up flipping?
Certainly, particularly when they're people like Michael Cohen who aren't career criminals, who haven't, who aren't prepared for that. You know, in other words, there were times when I prosecuted people who were working in drug cartels. Well, those people they go into that business knowing that a long prison term is a very much a possibility. White collar defendants, for them, a year, 2, 3 years in prison is a very, very long time. Typically, when the pressure gets on, those people ultimately make the decision to cooperate. Mm-hmm.
Very quickly, Karen McDougal has settled her lawsuit with AMI, the parent company of the Enquirer here. She's now free to say whatever she wants, even though she really already said whatever she wants to Anderson Cooper in this interview. What's the upshot of this right now?
Well, I think, now she certainly can make use of her fame. And, I think part of the upshot of that lawsuit for her is that we're talking about her on CNN. I think for her, she's somebody who no one knew, and she was able to get herself inserted into the news and make her story. And she got to meet Anderson Cooper. And, presumably that has some value to her, and perhaps her story. She has some details about her story she wants to share that'll have some additional value.
Renato Mariotto, thanks so much for being with us. Appreciate it.
Thank you.